magical movies to unforgettable adventures, from the thrill of the theater to the comfort of your home, you can always count on something new and exciting from Disney. Join us for a special preview from Walt Disney Pictures.
This I haven't seen in years. This is wonderful.
The child is in love with a prince.
Have you lost your senses completely? He's a human. You're a mermaid.
Teenagers, you give them an inch, they swim all over you.
The time has come to return. Walt Disney Pictures invites you back to the spectacular world of the Little Mermaid.
Look at you. There's something different.
She's got legs, you idiot.
Relive the timeless classic with Flounder, Sebastian, King Triton, Ursula the Sea Witch, Prince Eric, and of course, Ariel.
Wish I could be part of your world.
Isn't it fantastic?
The Little Mermaid.
I wouldn't miss it.
Coming only to theaters this holiday season.
I love you with all my heart, with every molecule, with every atom. I love you on a subatomic level.
This is going to be the very last time I try to marry you.
I'd rather die than disappoint you.
On the most important day of his life, Philip Brainerd, the world's most absent-minded professor, made a few little mistakes.
Oops.
Wow, what a bang.
And one gigantic flub.
Flubber.
Flubber?
Sounds like baby shampoo.
It's a metastable compound. If you apply a small amount of energy, it liberates an enormous quantity of energy.
This definitely has applications in the field of sports.
Oh, no!
When I exit this window, the flubber will send me right back up unharmed.
Are you nuts?
Ta-ta, my love.
Ouch.
Walt Disney Pictures presents...
Oh!
A classic story.
Mayday!
Oh, sorry. First time flyer.
Of boy meets goo.
Get him!
This Thanksgiving... Discover the stuff that dreams are made of.
Ow!
Robin Williams.
Hit the deck! It's Flubber!
Flubber.
Oh, boy.
Enjoy all the magic at home with these great Disney movies coming to video. Beauty and the Beast. It's everyone's favorite classic and the only animated film in history to be nominated for Best Picture. Now, get ready to be our guest for a perfectly enchanting new movie now in production.
Come on! What are we waiting for, Christmas?
Beauty and the Beast, The Enchanted Christmas. It's the world premiere of a brand new Disney classic coming only to video. A never-before-told chapter in the Beauty and the Beast legend. The classic tale of a young girl, her enchanted friends, and the one thing that just might touch the heart of a beast, the spirit of Christmas. Beauty and the Beast, The Enchanted Christmas, reunites all the original cast.
Go for it!
Including Robbie Benson, Paige O'Hara, Jerry Orbach, David Ogden Stiers, and Angela Lansbury. And two new star-studded voices, Tim Curry as Forte the Evil Pipe Organ, and Bernadette Peters as Angelique the Castle Decorator.
Oh, Lumiere.
Ah, Angelique, mon amour.
These new friends join your favorite characters singing five show-stopping songs.
As long as there's Christmas, I truly believe.
Don't miss the most enchanting new Disney movie of the year that you can add to your video collection. Beauty and the Beast, The Enchanted Christmas. The world premiere is only on video November 11th. Walt Disney Home Video is proud to bring you three timeless Disney classics. Filled with fun and excitement, these three great Disney movies will soon be available, giving you three more reasons to visit the Disney section of your store in October.
Look for the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities.
And don't miss your chance to own one of the greatest movies of all time.
You'd better believe it.
The song-filled celebration of Walt Disney's 19th animated masterpiece, The Jungle Book.
Crazy.
Join the unforgettable characters on this spectacular adventure, featuring some of the greatest music ever written for the big screen.
Ooby-doo! I want to be like you.
Hop-de-hooby-doo-bop.
I want to walk like you. Chip. Talk like you.
Choo-choo.
Available in a fully restored 30th anniversary edition, it's the last animated masterpiece to have Walt Disney's personal touch. The most outrageous classic of them all, Walt Disney's The Jungle Book.
Take me home, Daddy.
Don't miss all the fun of these timeless Disney classics. Available soon to add to your collection. Three more great reasons to visit the Disney section of your store. Only from Walt Disney Home Video. Coming to video in 1998, it's the classic tale of a legendary hero that critics are calling the most entertaining movie of the year. Disney's 35th animated classic, Hercules.
What was that name again?
Hercules.
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 Yeah, I mean, Hercules is
very popular.
Thank you.
Who was the Latin gladiator?
Hercules.
The mighty Hercules, Phil, Pegasus, Meg, Hades, and Pain and Panic.
Coming, you most lugubrious nymph.
All your favorite characters in this great Disney classic.
Two thumbs way up.
Filled with unforgettable adventure. Unforgettable fun.
I'm an action figure.
And all new music.
Get in.
Zero the hero in no time fast. Zero the hero just like that.
Now you can own the smash hit of the summer on video for the very first time.
Lucy, I'm home.
Disney's 35th animated classic, Hercules.
We dance, we kiss, we schmooze, we carry on, we go home happy. What do you say? Come on.
Thanks for joining us for this special preview. And now, our feature presentation.
In 1977, producer-director George Lucas created the Star Wars trilogy and changed the way we looked at movies. Now, 20 years later, using new digital technology, Lucas and his creative teams at Lucasfilm, THX, Skywalker Sound, and Industrial Light and Magic have completely restored, enhanced, and added to these classic movies to create the Star Wars Trilogy Special Edition. For the trilogy's second installment, The Empire Strikes Back, Lucas supervised the addition of brand new footage, as well as an enhanced look for many of the film's key scenes and locations.
Once I started to redo the first film, it became such a good experience that I said, well, gee, we should go back and finish the other two films too.
I'm not afraid.
You will be.
One of the problems I had is one of the sequences with the Wampa ice monster. The monster that was developed originally didn't work, so I had to jettison that monster. I had Phil Tippett create a little tiny hand puppet, which we were able to use in two shots. It was just the head. And we just did it at the last minute to stick it in. But the rest of the sequence was sort of cut around the monster, where you hear it, but you don't see it. And there's a certain creative way of doing that. I mean, you can do it where you don't see the monster, and some people would say that's more artistic than actually showing it, but in this particular case, I really wanted to see the monster, and I felt it would add more tension to the scene and make it more interesting. So we were able to do that. I was able to go back, create a better version of the monster, and shoot the scene and all the cutaways to the monster and add them into the scene, which I think makes that ice scene make more sense than it did before. The snow battle was a challenge when we did it because nobody had ever done blue screen matting on a white surface. You usually do it on dark surfaces.
Here we go then. Action!
We used optical technology, of course, to do all that compositing. And a telltale sign that something's been optically composited is a black line around it. And when you have a sequence that takes place in outer space against stars, it's easy to reach a point where those black lines don't show up. But when you have a sequence that takes place against snow in the daylight, every hint of that black matte line becomes very visible. And so the first time through doing the snow battle here 17 years ago, a lot of effort went into finding ways to minimize that black line. One of the ways was to not print all of the elements at their full opacity.
All right, I'm coming in.
Consequently, when you see the snow battle on film, you may notice that there's part of the scenery is visible through the cockpit. And it was a constant trade-off of how transparent can we make the cockpit? At what point is the black line more objectionable than the transparency? And so there was an opportunity to go back into those shots, use the computer technology, and eliminate all the transparency, but also not have any matte lines.
The other issue was going into Cloud City. Cloud City was a very difficult thing to design and create originally as a floating city in the clouds. Some of the mat work there wasn't very good. And when they built the set, it's very confined. It's a very small set. It doesn't look out onto anything. It's just, you get this, it's a very claustrophobic kind of set. And that always bothered me. I wanted to be more open, see more of the city. And so what we've done is we've added to the approach of the city, similar to what we did with Mos Eisley in Star Wars. I mean, there's many more shots coming up to the city. You get to see more of the city. You get to see more speeders and those sorts of things. And then at the same time, when they land and they start walking through the city, now they walk through and there's large windows, you can see out and see more of the city, and it opens it up and makes it much larger. Be able to pull back and see these grand visions of balconies and the city beyond and all that kind of stuff. To do that before was almost impossible. And now we can do it. We're doing it, you know, we have moving shots, we have all kinds of things that they just weren't able to do before. It just was not possible up until a few years ago.
My ally is the Force, and the powerful ally it is.
Now, sit back and get ready to experience George Lucas's definitive vision of The Empire Strikes Back, the second installment in the Star Wars Trilogy Special Edition.